Please rise. Behold, the Lord, the Mighty One, has come, and kingship is in his grasp, and power and dominion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are the light for all the nations. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christ Jesus, you are the revelation of God's love. Christe eleison. Lord Jesus, you are the Savior of the world. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk in your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, shall come bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord.
Lord, thanks be to God.
Mm-hmm.
on earth will adore you. O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice and your afflicted ones with judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Lord, every day. The kings of Tarshish and the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Seba shall bring tribute. All kings shall pay him homage. All nations shall serve him.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and the prophets by the Spirit. That the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Return, Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Know, dear brothers and sisters, that as we have rejoiced at the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, so by leave of God's mercy, we announce to you also the joy of his resurrection, who is our Savior. On the 13th day of February will fall Ash Wednesday, and the beginning of the fast of the most sacred Lenten season. On the 31st day of March, you will celebrate with joy Easter Day, the Paschal Feast of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the 12th day of May will be the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the 19th day of May, the Feast of Pentecost. On the 2nd day of June, the Feast of the Most Holy Body and Blood of Christ. On the 1st day of December, the first Sunday of the Advent of our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom is honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. Twenty hikers gathered early in the morning at the trailhead outside of Breckenridge, Colorado, and they were waiting for their guide. On their way there, they had seen the top of the mountain Mount Quandary. But now they were too close to see anything other than the trail and the forest. The hikers were in age between 16 and 55, all in fairly good shape. They were from out east, New York to be exact, and they knew very little about hiking up a 14,000-foot mountain in Colorado. So they hired a park ranger on his day off to guide them. Now, at first, they started off with a very brisk pace, full of enthusiasm. But an hour into the hike, most were panting from the effort as well as the altitude. Some were beginning to wonder if they could make it to the top. But they all supported one another, encouraged each other, and they kept following the guide. Finally, they crossed the tree line, and they could see the bald head of the Quandary summit. More encouragement, though, was needed, for even the strongest of them was still wondering. But they continued on. They persevered on their journey all the way to its conclusion. And there they stood on the peak, and they could see most of eastern Colorado and its glorious Rocky Mountains. Over there was Mount Evans, and when they turned to the south in the distance, they could see Pike's Peak. It was awesome. It was beautiful. And they left very happy, not just from what they saw, but also from how they completed that journey that day. Now, surely they could have paid a lot of money and hired a small plane or a helicopter to take them through the Rockies, but that wouldn't be the same. They never would have appreciated the peaks if they had not undertaken the hike, the journey. A long time ago, the Magi embarked on a journey. They had seen the star in the heavens. It was a star like none other, and it beckoned them. These Magi, you see, were pagans, and they were searching. They were hungering. They were thirsting. They were looking for answers, and they often looked to the sky for those answers. As astrologers, advisors to kings, they beheld that one star, and that star beckoned them with its light and invited them on a long, long and tiring journey. And off they went, and the light led them through all sorts of places, deserts and oases, mountains and valleys, dangerous places as well as friendly. And finally, it brought them to Bethlehem, where they found a king, but a king like no other king that their eyes had ever beheld, the King of all kings, the light of nations, Jesus Christ. And like the shepherds, they saw and they believed. All of us here today are on a similar journey,
Like the Magi, we have a sense of wonder, and we too have a hunger and a thirst and a desire to fill the darkness and the emptiness that this world sometimes only gives us. We have a sense of where we need to go, but we cannot see the destination. And like those hikers in the story, we know that the peak is somewhere out there, but we cannot yet see it. We have a guide. The guide is not a star, nor is it a park ranger. We know who that guide is. The guide is the light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being, consubstantial with the Father. Our guide is Jesus Christ. He is the light of nations, the light of this world. And is that the light that we follow? For he is the one and true light. Now, our journey is not easy. Sometimes it's very long, tedious, and difficult. And sometimes we might want to quit. Sometimes we just feel utterly exhausted. But like those hikers in Colorado, we encourage each other on that journey. We support each other. But most importantly, we keep our eyes and our hearts fixed on the light who is Jesus. What is it that we will find at the end of the journey when it's all over? Will it be a mountaintop, or will it be a baby lying in a manger? No, but what we will find at the end of that journey will be awesome and beautiful. You see, we are on a journey with Christ to his Father in heaven. We are being beckoned, invited always by God's grace to journey along the way. And we are being led to the one who the philosophers of old called the culmination of all truth, all goodness, and all beauty. We are journeying with Christ to heaven. Way back in 1857, John Henry Hopkins wrote a very beautiful Christmas carol for this feast of Epiphany. We just sang it at the beginning of our liturgy. Now, perhaps he was writing about those mysterious magi who traveled so long ago to find the Christ. But I really think he was writing about our journey as well. Listen again to those words. It's not only about those magi. It's our song as well. Star of wonder, star of night, star of royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, and for us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Just as surely as God's star led the Magi to find the infant, so will God guide us to fullness of life. Let us pray for this guidance, and our response is, light from light, shine on us this day. Light from light, shine on us this day.
For the church and for all those new to our faith, for those who have returned to the Catholic faith, and for those who heard the good news throughout the world and evangelize, may they find new ways to bring solidarity to the world through Christ, we pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day.
For our country, for new laws enacted that they nourish a healthy society which promotes a meaningful life through full employment, good education, medical care, shelter for those who are underprivileged, treatment of the frail, elderly, and disabled in a compassionate way, and fostering loving and connected families, we pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day.
That as we recall the Epiphany, we remember the wise men from the East who followed the star to Bethlehem and found God manifested in the beauty and innocence of a babe. May we be wise followers of the light and light bearers to the world, looking for Christ in the most unlikely and humble places, we pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day.
We pray for the homeless, for those who suffer from illness, for those who are homebound and those who are caregivers. May they know the loving comfort of the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day.
For our faith community, as we begin to prepare for the new year's many projects, for those preparing for baptism, confirmation, first communion, or marriage, for all who come to our parish seeking assistance, we pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day.
For all those who have died and for those who are dying, for those who are afraid to die, that they may find courage and peace. Let us remember Bernice Tulip, who died this past week, and all who have died. In particular, we remember at the Masses this weekend, Judy Burns Diderick, William Dossie, Gertrude Marone, and James Brucius. We pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day.
In a special way, we pray for those who have asked for our prayers, for those petitions in our Book of Intentions and those on our prayer lines, for those who are in most need of our prayers, and for those prayers we hold in our hearts. We pray.
Light from light, shine on us this day. O God, your light guides us to fullness of life. Hear these, our prayers that we offer you, and bring us to life everlasting. We pray this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Star in the east on Christmas morn. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. It will lead to the place where the Christ was born. Rise up, shepherd, and
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor, Lord, we pray on these your gifts of your church, in which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, But he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Benedict, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, eternal with you in your glory, appeared in a human body, truly sharing our flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying,
"Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying,
"Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. And to us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace, thank you. Peace, thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
And to fall.
Please be seated. Prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
Do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host.
By the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Let us pray. Renewed by sacred nourishment, we implore your mercy, O Lord. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who's called you out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon you and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters.
Amen.
And so when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light from light, who is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The tradition of Epiphany is for the priest to go to every house in the parish and to bless it. Well, they had more priests back then and probably smaller villages as well. But eventually what developed was the blessing of the chalk, and I will bless that chalk silently in a moment, and then I encourage everybody to take a piece of that chalk home with them, along with the instruction sheet. You take that blessing home with you and find one of the main doorways in your house and inscribe on that door with the chalk the first two numbers of the current year, the 2 and the 0. And then the initials of the 3 wise men, also the first 3 letters of the Latin words for may God bless this house, and then the final 2 letters of the current year, the 1 and the 3, and then there's another prayer to say on there as well. So let us pray. And the Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let us songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. Here rules the world, truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love,
and wonders of His love. We do have hospitality also in the back.